Jesus, we give you praise and we give you
understand why I lift my hand down, why I say amen, and why I do my dance. I may not be driving fancy cars, hanging with the stars. Ain't got that house in the hills, see, that may be a thrill, but I know the man upstairs, and I know he can. Move on out of my way. Gotta get on my feet. I just can't sit still. may not understand. Why I sing for you,
sing for you,
why I live for you,
live
and
for you,
why I long for you, just like the deer that
panted
after the water. My soul longs for you, Lord. My soul need you.
They don't even know my story.
If they knew, they'd be happy for me. See, your blessing is coming. You gotta stop running. Hold on a little longer. And if you hold on,
right, and God bless you. This is your man Tony Gill from the Tony Gill Show. Welcome again to today, Thursday. I hope God is blessing you and where all of you believe in God is for. You just heard from Kashara Tony called Great Day, and then you heard my new one called Yet I Praise Him Jesus, recorded right here in Houston, Texas. We're going to be bringing some nice great music from the great artists around the country, Anthony White and Donald Gill and Rusty Watson and Joseph Price and Everett Drake, Eric Carrington, Daryl J. Jones, and Kevin Peabody, just a host of other great artists and be coming on with you, and Donald Lawrence, and just playing you a lot of great music. So call your people, call your friend, tell them to check us out right now on the line, on the radio, right now on the air, serving you all around the globe. So we'll be right with you for at least an hour and a half, maybe two hours today. Thank you for listening. Sit right there. Take your shoes off. And here's the one by Anthony White. Don't need nobody else out of St. Louis, Missouri to help me praise the Lord. We'll be right back. Keep it locked where you got it.
that better days are dawning and that I'll receive everything the Lord told me was coming, and so I'll stand through the storm and the rain, knowing I'll survive. I'll be alright. But Lord, it gets hard, yes it does, when the years they keep on passing and I look around, oh Lord, and others they seem to surpass me, but still I stand, knowing that your word is true and that you will do just what you said you would do. But all I have left is my faith, for the storms of life took my strength away. All I have left is my faith. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things not seen. So whether sunshine or rain, whether joy or in pain, I believe, yes, I still believe, but all I have left, Lord, is my faith. I believe, but the storms of life, they took all my strength away, way, way. All I have left, all I have left is my faith, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Lord, I'm holding on and I won't let go.
The waves
may crash in the billows.
I know that you are.
All right, all right. That's a brand new one by Johnny Sanders. All I Have Left is faith. I want to send a blessing. God bless you out to Paige, and thank you for listening today. Great hearing from you. Great the knowing that you are listening to the show today. And I want to say thank you very much, Mr. Paige Turner Jr. Thank you for listening today, and everybody else listening around the country, to everybody to tune in to Tony Gill Show. We're gonna keep the music going right here. God bless you. Keep on listening. Tell your family, tell your friends. Be a blessing. Thank you. I am blessed by Kevin Peabody. Out of St. Louis, Missouri.
Are you blessed? When I look back over my life, I can truly say I am blessed. I've had to suffer pain and strife. Oh, I am blessed. Oh, I'm blessed when I'm walking in. I'm blessed when I'm walking out. Oh, I'm blessed when I'm going. I'm going. Put food on my table, clothes on my back. I can truly say I am blessed. Thank God I did not have a stroke or a heart attack. Oh, I am blessed. Oh, I'm blessed when I'm walking. I am blessed when I'm walking out. Oh, I'm blessed when I'm
showed me his amazing power, and now I can testify I made it.
By faith, I know it was your grace and mercy that kept me every day. When tests and trials seems to weigh me down, you gave me the strength to turn my frown upside down. I said, I'm glad,
I'm glad,
so, so glad,
so glad,
I made it,
I made it,
I made it,
I made it.
Said, lost my mind and I didn't know what to do. You see, I kept the faith, I kept running this race, and I'm so glad I'm standing here today. So I'm glad, so glad,
so glad
I made it.
I made it.
You got it. Come on and help me say.
I made it.
Help me say, I made it.
I
made it through the storm.
I made it.
I made it.
I made it
through my fears.
I
said, I made it.
I
made it through my sickness.
I
made it.
I
made it through my disappointments. How many can testify?
Woo!
I made it.
I
made it through my struggles.
What it do? It's your boy Bam Bam the Voice. You know I'm rocking with my boy Tony Gill on the Tony Gill Show. Now for 15 years, he's been interviewing artists and playing their music just like me. And for that, I want to say thank you. So log on, tune in, turn those speakers up. This is the Tony Gill Show.
He's on right now. that's God above. God of righteousness, a God of peace, a God of justice, everything you need. The seas, God of the rivers and the streams, the earth, the sky, moon and the stars, all things great are small. He's God, he's God, nobody like him, his name is God.
Right, that was a brand new one from Rusty Rotson. He was out of St. Louis, Missouri as well, but I think he's up in San Francisco or California around about now. Thank you all for listening. Also, we just heard from one of my good friends out of Houston, Texas, Eric Carrington, with his new "What I Made It." So we can be trying to bring some more new ones. Every Drake is coming up, and we got Donald Lawrence. We got some more great music for you coming up. I'm going to send a shout out on the God Bless You to a lady friend of mine, Miss Ronika. I hope I pronounced her name right. Thomas out of St. Louis, Missouri. She's going to be coming on the show pretty soon. She's a doctor. She's a motivational speaker, a trainer, a life coach, author, and a PhD. She also the founder and CEO at Big League Executive Coaching. She's out of St. Louis as well. She's going to be coming on the show pretty soon this year. Soon we hook it up and get it together for you. I want to tell her God bless her and thank her that she's listening, and all the people in St. Louis and everywhere else that's listening to us, everywhere around the nation, around the globe, especially the people over in Africa that are always listening to us and listen to my show, and they call me and tell me what a blessing it is. But Dr. Newsom, thank you for listening, everybody. Everywhere, God bless you. Keep it locked right where you got it. Here's the one by Donald Lawrence featuring Hezekiah Walker. One of my favorites. I play it all the time. One of my favorites. And it's going to be your favorite too, called "God Covered Me." I know y'all going to like it. So stay where you got it. God bless you and see you in a few minutes.
Your hands, I'm glad the hand of the Lord is around us. You know what I mean?
Donald, if it wasn't for God's covering grace, I wouldn't be alive right now.
This is just a simple song.
I could have lost in my mind. Wanted to give up so many times. But God was my anchor, a consistent way maker. Yes, I'm grateful God covered. Go on and sing the song, Pastor. Well, the enemy came against me. You called me about it. Attack my body and my ministry. But what God ordains, He will maintain. I'm grateful He covered me.
Come on, everybody, let's sing the song.
Feel the song the way you wanna feel. Well, the enemy came against me. You called me about it. Attack my body and my ministry. But what God ordains, He will maintain. I'm grateful He covered me.
Oh, everybody, come on, sing it.
You covered.
If it wasn't for your grace,
God and your mercy.
for your hand of protection all around us. We know that when the enemy comes in like a flood, you lift up a standard. No weapon formed against us shall ever, ever prosper. Come on, Pastor, let's do this together.
You cover me, hands of protection around me, your grace.
Don't basement is where your knees will drop. If your name ain't found in the book of life, you're cast into the lake of fire, second death.
That's right.
It's painful, it ain't easy. Burning for eternity, in the burning flames. Should've called on his name, now you in pain. Lost in the fizzings, or what the shizzing.
The devil don't want you to hear me. Baby, hear me, hear me out. Baby, hear me, hear me out. The devil don't want you to hear me. Baby, hear me, hear me out. Baby, hear me, hear me out. The devil don't want you to hear me, hear me. Don't want you to hear me, hear me. The devil don't want you to hear me.
Tony Gill, don't stop what you're doing, man. Tony Gill, don't stop what you're playing, man.
Man, I'm enjoying the Tony Gill show.
Ah, you go ahead, Tony Gill. Play that gospel, Tony Gill. La, la, la.
This is your brother from another mother, God's messenger.
Oh.
So guess what? If you got fear, guess where it didn't come from? It didn't come from God. Now, again, you heard me say this, and I'll say it again. A lot of times you hear preachers even say this, and it's really out of order. They tell you, well, if you're afraid, just do it anyway. No, if you're afraid, you need to stop a moment. You need to encourage yourself, and then you go forward. Because what you do in fear, you just get sent to the devil.
Yeah.
He said, oh, you scared. I got you. Even, okay, y'all know I like animals. A dog know when you're scared.
Yes, he do. That's right.
You know what I say? The littlest dog know when you're scared.
That's right.
And you know what it does? It emboldens them. It makes them bolder at you.
Mm.
So the devil knows when you're afraid. You know what it does? It's emboldening them. It causes him to act up even more. Because they say, oh, just a little more and I'll get him to crack. So, we haven't received. Look at that 15th verse again. For ye have not received the spirit of what? Of bondage again. So now watch this. He said you have not received the spirit of bondage. Watch this. Again. Ye have not received it what?
Spirit of bondage again.
When?
Again.
Again. How? Again. So, evidently when you was born again, you no longer had the spirit of fear.
Mm-hmm.
Prior to that, the spirit of fear was operating in you.
Right.
So when you got born again, when you accepted God's word, you accepted Jesus the Christ, then you no longer had that spirit of fear. So watch this. If I don't have that spirit, then where does that spirit come from again? It comes from Satan. So when you get afraid about something, you need to encourage yourself in the Lord and say, no, devil, uh-uh. You can't have nothing here.
That's right.
And you need to understand what the scripture says. Scripture says, resist the devil, and it says he will flee.
Uh-huh.
What's he going to do?
Flee.
He's going to flee. If you resist, now how again do you resist the devil?
Submit to God.
You do what God say do. That's how you don't be to me, oh, no, devil, no, devil, no, devil, I resist you in Jesus' name. No, you obey the word of God. You do what God say do. When you do what God say do, then you're resisting the devil, because when you do what God say do, the devil ain't got nothing to do with you. He can't touch this.
Can't touch it.
That's right.
Y'all hear what I'm saying? See, we give him too much credit. See, and it's a terrible thing going in the body of Christ of giving the devil too much credit. Every time I look up, here come the devil. The devil busy. Well, what about God?
Lord have mercy. That's it. God is
busy. I don't think the devil getting more busy than God.
All right now.
You got the scripture talks about the heavens and said that one third of the heavens, the angels,
yes,
fell with Satan.
Fell.
Mm-hmm. Doing his work. That means two thirds are left.
That's it.
So whose work do you think they're doing?
Boys, boys, then all against us. That's right.
Go to Hebrews chapter 1 so I can show you. But keep Romans, we're coming back. Hebrews chapter 1. Y'all here? You got to get it, saints. And then even if all of the angels fail, who is God? Who's greater than God? Who can be greater than God even though it may be more in number? Nobody. Y'all here? Now watch this in Hebrews chapter 1, verse number 13. But to which of the angels said he at any time, sit on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool? Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? So the angels that are on God's side are ministering spirits for you.
That's right.
Amen.
So there's twice as many of them around as it is fallen ones. So what you got to be afraid of?
That's right. Come on now.
Come on. What you have to be afraid of?
What?
So you cannot continue to listen to the reports of the world and get in fear. Isaiah says like this, whose report do you believe? And whom shall the arm of the Lord be revealed? The arm of the Lord represents the might of God, the power of God, the ability of God. So who is it revealed to? The ones that believe the report of the Lord. If you believe the Lord over you believe in what the world's saying, then the arm of God will be revealed to you in what you believe. If you don't believe you can make it, guess what? You won't. If you don't believe you're more than a conqueror, guess what? You are not. But if you believe what the words say about you, that's exactly who you are and exactly what you can do. I'm telling the truth. Praise the Lord. So go back to Romans 8. So the angels are ministering spirits for who? So that means you have no reason to be concerned about Satan and his fallen angels. Matter of fact, the angel Gabriel fought for Daniel. The scripture talks about how he withstood. He was withstood by the prince of Persia. So he had to call Michael to help him. So he had him help. Romans 8. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage, verse 15 again, to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. So what it's simply saying is you have been adopted into the family of God, and because you've been adopted into the family of God, you have nothing to fear. Because why? Because God now is your source. God is your protection. You got it? So if God is all that to me, then I don't have anything to fear. Can y'all see that? So we haven't received that. Watch this. To fear again. Mm-hmm. Some people say fear is healthy. Fear is not healthy. Mm-hmm. It can't be.
No.
If it's healthy, then why is it killing folk?
All right, listen. Mm-hmm. The Bible is true.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Look with me at 1 Corinthians 2. Then I'm going to give you some points. 1 Corinthians 2. Now, I may have to kind of stay here just a moment on this one. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Say amen if you had it. Amen. It's woe if you don't. So everybody got it?
Amen.
Verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world.
That's it.
We have not received what?
The spirit of the world.
But the spirit which is of who?
God.
Of God. That we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. Of who?
God.
Which things also we speak not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Ghost teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them because they are spiritually discerned. So what is he saying here to us again? We have not received the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God. You got God's spirit.
Right.
And you have God's spirit, so to watch this, so that you can know the things that are freely given to you from God. So guess what? Everything God give me is free. Anybody here beside me? That's why you got to understand grace. That's why you got to understand the goodness of God. Every good and perfect gift comes from God.
Hallelujah.
It comes from above.
That's right.
You got it? So nothing but good comes to me, my family, my church, and my country. Everything good comes. I'm not looking for anything bad to come. I'm not setting myself up for some bad things to come. I'm not sitting around planning and hoping bad things come.
That's right. Come on, Pastor.
No. 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 I'm going to give you some more stuff in just a second. But it's of God, right? You have the spirit of God. Would you look at your name and say, you have the spirit of God in you? Come on, look at somebody, tell them you have the Spirit of God in you.
You have the Spirit of God in you.
Everybody tell somebody.
You have the Spirit of God in you.
Don't be scared.
See?
You think somebody going to think funny of you because you telling them that. All right. Now, you ready? This is some definition I want to give you again. So get ready to write. Fear is an uneasiness of mind. Fear is an uneasiness of mind upon the thought of future evil that will befall you. Fear is uneasiness of mind. Of what? Uneasiness of mind. And basically it's because you fear some evil, or you're thinking about some evil that's going to come on you.
Yeah.
It's just like I was talking about with the fuel prices. Oh, it's going up. It's going up. So your mind don't rest. Mm-hmm. So we're thinking on the wrong stuff.
That's right.
The scripture says he'll keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind on him.
Stayed on him. Yes. Glory
right?
To God.
So fear is an uneasiness of mind. What's going to happen to me? Mm-hmm. Can y'all see that?
Yes, sir.
So what you have to do is you have to say again and adopt what God gave us is there is nothing but good comes to me, my family, my church, and my country.
That's
nothing
right.
But good.
Nothing but good.
And then you have to believe that. You have to rest in that.
Hallelujah.
You can't just be saying it and don't believe it.
Right.
Saying it at this side of the mouth and looking for trouble over here.
Yeah.
Anybody here beside me?
Amen.
Now, It's another thing I want to say to you about fear. Fear is a state of mind that brings about restlessness. That's another way to say it. Fear is a state of mind. And that's what I want you to understand. Fear actually is a state of mind.
Mm-hmm.
Where does fear start? In the mind. Because you start seeing things and thinking about what's going to happen to you. Can you see that?
Yes.
And the most part, when you start thinking like that, you start thinking negative thoughts. You start thinking about, oh, I'm not going to make it. Nobody got a job for me. I got these children. What am I going to do? You're going to trust God. That's what you're going to do.
That's right.
If I can just get a man. You don't need no man if he ain't got one already. If I can just get him to take care of his children. No, if you can get God to take care of your children. If a man don't want
to
act right, hey. Sure, he's supposed to do right.
That's right.
But he ain't your source.
That's right. Glory.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, it's three enemies. Say enemies.
Enemies.
Three enemies you're going to have to deal with if you're going to overcome fear, if you're going to break the grip of fear. Three enemies you're going to have to deal with. You ready? One is you're going to have to deal with indecision. Make up your mind. Either God is who he says he is to you or he's not. Indecision. Two is doubt. Doubt. Doubt breeds fear. And the third one again is fear itself. Now, why do you say that? Because indecision and doubt crystallizes fear.
That's it. Come on.
Indecision, not being able to make a decision.
That's right.
And doubt crystallizes into fear. You got it? Come on. We're going to deal with it. So it's six major areas of fear that I want to deal with during this teaching. Six major areas.
Come on now.
You ready? Mm-hmm. One is the fear of poverty. Fear of poverty. Two is the fear of criticism. Three, fear of ill health. Four is the fear of loss of someone's love. The fear of loss of someone's love. Five, fear of aging. Oh, I'm getting old and Arthur riding. Six, the fear of death. So many people are in bondage from the fear of death. I ain't getting on that cruise ship. I can't drink all that water.
Talk about dealing with the fear of death.
Well, I like to see you fill your bathtub up and drink all that water. But you get in the tub, don't you? You probably couldn't drink all the water and come out your shower head, but you get in the shower. See the logic of things that we how we think? You know, if God want man to fly, he'd have gave him wings. He did. He gave man knowledge of the plane. All right, let's look at this real quick. So we're going to start with poverty. Now, let me tell you one of the things, first of all, let me make this statement to you. There's only one thing in life that you have absolute control over. I know you want to know, don't you? There's only one thing in life that you have absolute control over. That's the thoughts of your mind.
Your own mind. I said that best.
Your thoughts. Nobody can control your thoughts but you.
That's it.
You're the only one. You have absolute control over your own thoughts. You can't say somebody made me think like that. You thought like that because of you. Mm-hmm.
That's it.
And that's why the scripture says, as a man thinketh, so is he. Mm-hmm. So you have absolute control over your thoughts.
That's it.
So now, what I'm about to show you, now watch this. When it comes to the spirit of poverty, the fear of poverty, now watch this. When it comes to that, you can decide that you are going to receive poverty and nobody else can stop you. You can decide you're going to give into it. And can't nobody else change that for you.
That's right, no matter what they do.
Because it's your decision made in your own thoughts. You got it? There is more than enough abundance in this earth for everybody.
Yes. God.
And it's controlled by a few because the few have thought right about it. It is not because the few can keep you from having it.
That's right.
It's because you don't control your thoughts to get it. Y'all listen to me? It's the fear of the spirit of poverty. You got it? Now, poverty, let me give you a definition of what I mean by poverty. It's destitute of property, having nothing. Okay? Now watch this. And y'all, some of y'all might not like this because I know how we is. The consequences of poverty is dependence.
Oh, Lord.
The consequences of poverty is dependence. You depending on somebody else to take care of you. And if they don't take care of you, you're not going to make it in your own mind. You already done made up your mind. If you don't get that welfare check, you don't know what you're going to do.
Lord, have mercy.
You done already made up your mind that if so-and-so don't be the source of blessing you,
that's right.
Then you're not going to make it. So you're dependent on others rather than standing up for yourself.
Yeah, come on.
That's the consequences of poverty. Y'all listen to what I'm saying to you? Poverty is somebody that's in absolute want. Every time you look at it, they want. They're in want. They never had their need met. They want. They stay in that condition. And guess what? You can have a little money and still be in poverty.
That's right.
Y'all listen to me? Now, when I talk about riches, I want you to hear riches in a different tone. I'm talking about riches in the broadest sense, not just financial, okay, but total riches, even though the riches is the main thing most people miss because we think can't nobody have all this stuff. It's only for a few select people.
Mm-mm.
But we're going to get rid of that fear, right?
Hallelujah.
Right?
Hallelujah.
Y'all hear?
Hallelujah.
Riches in the broadest sense are financial, spiritual, mental, and material. You ought to be rich in every area, every one of those areas. You ought to be rich financially with money. You ought to be rich spiritually with your relationship with God. You ought to be rich not only those ways, but you ought to be rich mentally. Your mind ought to be sharp and strong because God gave you a powerful mind. God gave you a sound mind. So you ought not be whacked.
Right.
You ought to think soberly.
Think soberly.
Y'all hear?
Glory to God.
And the immature, you ought to have some stuff.
That's it.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There they go with that stuff. I have to talk about that, but God want everybody to have. God want everybody to have something.
That's right.
Every good and perfect gift comes from him, so he ain't giving
That's
you no
right.
junk.
That's right. Yep.
Y'all hear?
Yeah.
Well, just because you got stuff don't mean you prosperous. Well, I beg to differ with you. God shows all throughout the scripture how people have stuff, and he talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
Why he going to talk about Abraham and then talk about all the stuff that he had? Why are you talking about Isaac? Isaac sold in a time of famine, but Isaac was loaded.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Why are you talking about Job, everything Job had?
Mm-hmm.
Then why are you talking about when it was taken from Job, he got it back restored double?
Yes. Hallelujah.
Why are you talking about that? Because God is a loving, supplying father.
Mm-hmm.
And he don't enter in a relationship with people and don't bless them, don't take care of them. Well, I've been serving the Lord for a long time. He ain't done it. Oh, yeah, you just don't know how to get it. See? Because what happens to you, you can't get it being disobedient.
That's it, Pastor.
You got to learn how to obey God. If you are willing and obedient, you obey God, and God will unleash anything and everything you want in life.
Yes.
Nothing is too good for a child of God. And God's, the scripture says he will withhold no good thing from them that walk upright. So the key to having good stuff is to do what's right. Y'all hear what I'm saying? So you can't blame God if you broke.
That's true.
You can't.
That's true.
You can blame God all you want, but you blaming the wrong one.
Stand up in court.
See? Because it ain't God's fault that you don't obey him.
Mm.
It ain't God's fault that you don't even know how to obey him because nobody taught you how. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. So, now watch this. If you're willing to accept poverty, you may as well make up your mind and receive it. Because you're going to have to learn how to make a demand on riches of life and stop accepting junk. You listen to what I said? What most people do is they bargain for a penny and God trying to make you rich.
That's right.
Yes.
What do you mean by that, Pastor? Lord, if I just had just enough to do this, Lord, just give me enough to do that. God trying to get you in an overflow. He trying to get you an abundant supply so you don't have to be begging him like that.
Jesus.
And hey, listen to me, another thing too. It ain't about your job. Not with God. God said, if you give, it's given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shake together, running over, shall men give unto you. But it didn't say job. So when you obey God, you have a right to expect things to come and you finance coming to you from everywhere.
Everywhere. Thank you, Jesus.
But what we do is stupid stuff. Now, y'all excuse my slang. We do stupid things. God tries to get a channel flowing to you, and you say, oh, that's okay. Somebody want to give you $5. And you say, oh, that's okay. Thank you. Well, why have somebody come give you $100 if you won't take the $5?
All right, now.
Because you're too proud to take $5 from somebody. But it's a system of God where God causes somebody to give to you because when they give to you, then somebody going to give to them. It's a system, and when you break the system, then you break what God's doing, and you knock that person out the saddle because that's the one that God spoke to give it to you, and they can't be obedient to God because of you. Because you're so proud. Amen.
And
ote. Y'all hear me? My grandchildren will come. If they got money and they won't give me money, I take it from my grandchildren. I sure do. You know why I take it from my grandchildren? Because I want them blessed.
Yeah, that's right.
And I want them always to understand giving.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't talking about, oh, that's okay, so you ain't got to put a dollar. No, give it here. You're going to give it to me? Fine, I take it.
That's right.
And I speak blessing over you for giving it. But you got to understand the system of God in order to do things like that. But that old lady on a fixed income, well, no, she ain't, not if she giving. Amen. You can't fix nothing when God say that he going to cause things to come to you as a result of doing that. You ain't fixed nothing. You done open it up.
Yes.
That's what you've done. God. But what we've done is we've limited God to what we can earn through a paycheck. And I'm telling you, that takes a whole new dynamic of thinking. That takes a whole new way of looking at things, looking at life. Because most of us, we think the only way we're going to get blessed is if we got a job. Yeah. Not that you shouldn't work. Amen. But don't look at your job as your source. Your source is always God.
Yes.
You'd be in Timbuktu somewhere and somebody don't even know you and come up and give you money because God spoke to him to give it to you.
That is so true, Pastor. That is so true. It happens all the time.
Y'all hear? Now, when you're in the poverty, what happens is it stops your imagination. Because all you can think about is what you need. But your imagination shuts down. Because you can't even dream past your stomach being hungry. All you can see is a biscuit or some kind of bread or something. You can't even see the things that can happen for your life. Praise the Lord. Y'all hear? Now I'm telling you, this take a different mindset altogether. Y'all hear what I'm saying to you? Because see, when you're in poverty, you think poor. That's why, you know, one of the things I've done now, and I give God glory. To build this building, I had to go places. Now y'all hear what I'm saying? I had to go where people were doing this.
Yeah, that's right.
I had to go in places and sit in buildings that were built like this.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Because before that, my limitation was what I had been exposed to. Mm-hmm. So I couldn't even imagine a church building like this.
Talk about that.
Can y'all see what I'm saying to you? So I would go to Oklahoma, go to Rhema. I would go out to California, out to Dr. Price's ministry, and different. I went somewhere everywhere. What was I doing? Changing how I saw things. The church I got saved in. Now watch this. It didn't see maybe 100 people. And when I was going to that church, I thought that was a big church. I'm serious. Because that's all I was used to. Y'all hear?
Yeah.
But then I had to get exposed to some other things. And so that showed me what really could happen. You understand? So from a poverty mind, I've seen 100. You can go way beyond that.
Amen. You've been listening to Breaking the Grip of Fear from Dr. Patrick Randolph, the pastor of Praise Christian Center in Channelview, Texas. We play that for the Bible study for everybody that's listening around the world, around the country, but at least especially for people over in Africa. They used it for their Bible studies. We try to get it on for them doing their Bible study. We want to bless them again and thank them for with their Bible study going on right now. Thank you all again for listening. That is Breaking a Grip of Fear. Breaking the Grip of Fear. And we all have that fear. We're going to play it some more again for you tomorrow evening as well. Breaking the Grip of Fear from Pastor Dr. Patrick Randolph at Praise Christian Center in Channelview, Texas. And right now we're going to send a God bless you and a shout out to my friends in St. Louis again. One of my great friends, one of my good buddies, been on for a long time, Michael Latcherson with the Michael Latcherson Singers. Man, great group of people, great singers, great writers, musicians. I want to send it back out to them again and do it again for them called This Is The Day. This is from one of their projects that they did in St. Louis, Missouri. So I want to send a shout out to them and their family, everybody in St. Louis listening. Here's my friend, my buddy, Michael Latcherson and Michael Latcherson Singers with This Is The Day.
The best hit music. Every time you turn us on.
Every time you turn us on, there's another hit song coming on.
Yo, what it do? It's your boy Bam Bam the Voice. You know I'm rocking with my boy Tony Gill on the Tony Gill Show. Now for 15 years, he's been interviewing artists and playing their music just like me. And for that, I want to say thank you. So log on, tune in, turn those speakers up. This is the Tony Gill Show.
Perhaps some of you remember this song.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm gonna lift you up.
Say it again.
Lord, we glorify you, and we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord,
is a privilege.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
gonna
lift you up.
Oh,
Lord, we glorify you,
and we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm gonna lift you up.
And we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord, is a privilege. I'm gonna lift you up.
Listen. From the rising of the sun,
I'm gonna lift you up.
Thank you, Jesus, until the sun is long gone. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you're worthy of praise.
I
think I'll praise you all my days. Lord, we
glorify you.
And we lift you up.
Serving you,
Lord.
Say
it again, say it again, say it again, say it again.
And we lift you up.
Serving you, Lord. Up in the presence of the Lord. Say Tahila.
Tahila.
It means to sing.
Come on, make some noise over here. Say it again, say Shabbat.
And his word declares he inhabits the praises of his people. So as you praise him,
we
hit music. Every time you turn us on.
Every time you turn us on, there's another hit song coming on.
This is for everybody who's been restored. D. Lawrence coming at you. Get up. Come on, y'all. Let's sing this song. Ah.
Got a story to tell you.
Yeah.
Some things that happened, but I'm here.
Yo, I'm here.
Oh, I'm here.
I like that.
Had some ups, had some downs.
Oh, you only knew.
But I'm here.
Right now, I stand before you.
Oh, I'm here.
Stand here.
Oh, I'm here.
Thank you, Lord.
Had some sunshine, some rain.
Yeah.
Heartache and some pain. I'm here.
I'm here.
Oh, I'm here.
Oh, listen.
My God has touched me.
God touched me.
Delivered.
He delivered.
He said,
yeah.
I'm so free.
Now my heart is mended.
My heart is mended.
Oh, I'm whole again.
I'm whole again.
You see, there's no change. Guess what? Got my liberty. I'm here. Yeah. Oh, say it, y'all. God touched me. Yeah. Oh, he set my soul.
He set my soul free.
Anybody free like me? Anybody mend? There's liberty. Yeah. I like this part. I may have some scars.
I am here.
But I'm here.
Circumstances.
Still got some circumstances.
I'm still here.
But I'm still here.
Disappointment.
Yeah.
I am here.
But I'm still here.
Disappointment.
Many disappointments.
I am here.
Let's take it out.
Thank you.
this morning. I remember how we started the day together. Somehow we drifted apart. I need to feel your presence. All through the day. Sometimes
hit music. Every time you turn us on. Every time you turn us on, there's another hit song coming on.
A place of holy ground. Yeah, when we came into this place, we came into a place of holy ground.
Cause this is
All right. Let the praise begin with none other than Fred Hammond. Also, we're going to send a shout out to God. Bless y'all to Kevin Peabody. You know, we played his song, I Am Blessed, earlier. Also, he got a new Christmas song out as well. We're going to try to, you know, get that on for you again. I know we played it during the holiday, but we're going to try to get it on for you again. Maybe, hopefully not today, but tomorrow, to Kevin Peabody. Thank you all for listening, you know, and check him out now. He's out there on YouTube. He's out there on Facebook. He got projects out everywhere. That's my friend. We've been friends for a long time from East St. Louis, Macedonia. Baptist Church Pastor Nomi Orr Sr. He was the piano player, musician, also Mr. Music, I think, at one time, and all the organist. But yeah, take out Kevin Peabody. So right now, we're going to let you hear another brand new one from our friend. Tell you, we've been friends for a while as well. Mr. Everett Drake. Y'all got to check him out, too, out there. He got a lot of new music out there. But this one, one of my favorites, one I love. This is called Amen Goes Right There. From none other to Mr. Everett Drake. Amen goes right there. We'll be right back. You got it. what it do? It's your boy Bam Bam the Voice. You know I'm rocking with my boy Tony Gill on the Tony Gill Show. Now for 15 years, he's been interviewing artists and playing their music just like me. And for that, I want to say thank you. So log on, tune in, turn those speakers up. This is the Tony Gill Show.
Yeah. See, they gotta do this because I keep on going.
Tell me.
Tony Gill, don't stop what you're doing, man. Tony Gill, don't stop what you're playing, man. Man, I'm enjoying, man. I'm enjoying the Tony Gill show.
Ah, you go ahead, Tony Gill. Play that gospel, Tony Gill. La, la, la.
This is your brother from another mother, God's messenger.
Oh.
I'm gonna tell you about a man named Jesus. I don't care what you need. He will do it. Suddenly, it don't take all day or night, but he will do it suddenly.
Lift me up, lift me, once my life now, I see God gave me things for free. And he did it suddenly, and he did it suddenly.
Thank you again for listening to the Tony Gill Show today. This is your host, Tony Gill, and I thank everybody. Thank God for another blessed day. Thank God for blessing us and keeping us safe. I plead the blood of Jesus upon us to protect us, protect our families, our finances, our homes, our jobs, all our families everywhere in the United States, in the world, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I thank him. And keep on thanking the Lord that he give you desires of your heart. Thank you for listening to Gripping the Faith, Breaking the Grip of Faith with Dr. Patrick Randolph. Again, we're going to bring it again to you tomorrow evening. Thank all the artists for their music and everybody around the globe. Thank you for listening. Thank you, families. And we're going to see you again on tomorrow. It's been a good day. Thank God for a great, brand new day. Thank you. See you tomorrow.
Been a good day. It has been a good day.
The best hit music every time you turn us on.
I've had some heartaches and pain. A little sunshine.
Tony Gill, don't stop what you're some doing, man. Tony Gill, don't stop what you're playing,
some
man.
Some smiles and some frowns. But it's been a good day. Yes, it has. Thank you, love. Been a good day, yes it has. Cause I've got my help and strength. And I know that I'm his child. It's been a good day. And I thank God for it. It's been a good day.
I thank God for it.
I've been lied on and cheated, talked about and mistreated, up and down, had some smiles, had some frowns. Oh, it's been a good day. Take a little time to thank God for it. I want to thank God for it. I want to thank God for it. I want to thank God for it. All of my help and strength. I need to know that I'm a child. Leave, I take a little more.
Thank you, Lord,
for every blessing.
I've got my